You're watching NFL Daily here on Chat Sports. I am Harrison Graham, back with another video. We got the latest NFL rumors and news. Lots to jump into on today's video, including the latest on Dalvin Cook. We all expect him to hold out, but maybe we should pump the brakes on that because Arif Hasan of The Athletic suggests that he doesn't think it's very likely that the Vikings running back will actually hold out of training camp. Now, I guess technically he is quote-unquote holding out right now because he's not participating in team activities, hasn't in the last week or so. He is waiting for a new contract, holding out for a new contract, but it's not really a holdout unless you skip training camp because, look, it's virtual offseason right now. There's not a lot going on. There's not even in-person mini camp, so it's not like him not participating in team meetings, which isn't that much right now anyway, is missing a whole lot. Here's more from Hasan on this, saying the Vikings haven't had to deal with very many holdouts in their history, and Dalvin doesn't seem like the kind of guy who would. I'm confident the Vikings will get a deal done. So maybe he's suggesting he doesn't think there will be a holdout because a contract will come. But either way, Arif Hasan of The Athletic does not expect Dalvin Cook to skip training camp. He expects him to be there whenever that happens. Now, Cook wants to be paid like a top-flight running back. Some reports say he wants to be the highest paid. More reports suggest, though, he wants to be in that $13 million range. Get, you know, a Le'Veon Bell type of contract, if you will. I think he would settle for being the third highest paid running back on an annual basis behind Christian McCaffrey and Ezekiel Elliott, especially considering if you're the Vikings, you tell Dalvin, hey, you were really good in 2019, but you have dealt with injuries, especially your first 2 years in the NFL. So I'll set the over-under at $12 million. What do you guys think? What would you give him? Type O for over $12 million per year. Type U for under $12 million per year. I can't give him more than 12 or 13. It's right in that range. I'm curious what you think. O for over 12 or U for under 12. Now, Dalvin Cook, like I just mentioned, had an excellent season in 2019. If this is what you were getting every year, which is over 1,100 yards, 4.5 yards per carry, and 13 rushing touchdowns, plus pretty good production in the receiving game, I'll give him 12 or 13 million because that's a running back that can be the focal point of the offense and give you 1,600 or 1,700 yards in total production and double-digit touchdowns. The problem is when you look at his career right there on your screen there, 2017, missed a big chunk of the season. Same in 2018. Has some injury issues, some soft tissue concerns. So how long is he going to last? Do you want to give him 4 years and, you know, $65 million? I don't. I think that's a little bit too much for a guy who's got some muscular issues. So, again, really good player when he is healthy, and that is the key, especially when it comes to running backs. Now, Tom and I were live on Chat Sports last night for the MLB Draft Round 1 coverage. So we got some new subscribers. Maybe some of you guys are stumbling onto this video. If you are, I appreciate it. If you're new to Chat Sports and new to what we do, type new in the comment section. For those of you guys who've been around for a while, understand what we do, type old. Also, if you're new and you haven't subscribed, hit that big red button. You might get hit with the ad break. Type new, type old, also subscribe. Everson Griffen to Seattle. I think this is a possibility. Now, it ties into the Jadeveon Clowney stuff where we know he's turned down $15 million from the Seahawks. That's the latest report. So, latest indications are that Clowney is not going to end up in Seattle. Unless they circle back to him, unless he's willing to take less money than he wants to, that's not going to happen. So maybe the Seahawks say, okay, we'll set our sights on Everson Griffen, who is a productive pass rusher in his own right and can give us production at a cheaper cost. Let's look at the last four seasons for these two guys. Similar games, mostly healthy there, playing in 58 and 57 games out of 64 over the past 4 years. Now, Clowney's better against the run. That's why you see the more tackles there. But you could argue that Griffin's actually a better pure pass rusher. The sacks would suggest that. Now, the pass rush rate is a little bit closer than that. But Griffen is a really good player in his own right. He's a little bit older. Won't cost as much, doesn't give you as much against the run, but at a cheaper cost with at least as good pass rush ability, if not a little bit better, that might be the way to go if you are the Seattle Seahawks in the end, shifting your attention to Everson Griffen instead of Jadeveon Clowney. Now, what do you guys think? What is the better option for the Seattle Seahawks type? C for Clowney at $13 to $16 million per year, or Griffen at $8 to $11 million if you think that's a better option, type E. Again, C for Clowney at $13 to $16 million, or E for Everson Griffen at $8 to $11 million. All right, Seahawks fans and NFL fans, we've got our Stronger Together gear for you guys at chatsports.com/strong. Got the Seahawks one there. All 32 NFL teams, these shirts are at a really good reduced price right now, and it goes to a good cause. The proceeds go to the COVID-19 Relief Fund. It supports a good cause. These are quality t-shirts. They're at a good price. You can represent your favorite team at chatsports.com/strong, and with Father's Day around the corner, it's a perfect gift to get your old man. These t-shirts, they're like less than $20 right now, so take advantage. I'll put the link in the comments and in the description. It's chatsports.com/strong. I think the latest kind of fits that makes sense for Clowney. Seattle still makes sense, but I think Cleveland's more likely. They're, you know, pressing the issue on Clowney. He apparently turned down $18 million for them. We'll see if they up the price for Clowney there. Tennessee is, you know, a team that's been linked to him as well. I do think there's going to be more teams in the mix for Griffen because he's not going to cost as much. The Arizona Cardinals have expressed interest. Seattle, I think, is going to even get more interested as Clowney continues to fade away from their eyesight. The Cleveland Browns, if they don't get Clowney, could, you know, circle back to Griffen. Minnesota, Houston, I think Griffen's going to have plenty of suitors. We know partially why he's waiting is because he wants to meet with teams in person. Hopefully he's able to do that sooner rather than later. Now, you Seahawks fans, if you're watching this this cut here on our Seahawks channel, just hit that big red subscribe button. But if you're watching on our main Chat Sports YouTube channel, the link is below, chatsports.com/SeahawksTV. We're closing in on 1,000 subs on our Seahawks-only channel. I encourage you to subscribe. Congratulations, Cardinals fans. You have joined the Cleveland Browns on our Chat Sports Team Challenge leaderboard here at 100 subscribers. Just crossed it earlier today. You're at 103 on the Cardinals channel. Here's the deal. You're going to get a mailbag. So you Cardinals fans, use hashtag Cardinals for a mailbag video. We've got channels for all 32 NFL teams created. The Browns have reached the threshold of 100 subs. The Cardinals have reached it. Browns Q&A is coming up very soon. We're going to make one for the Cardinals now as well. It's not too late for your other teams. The Dolphins, we just showed you on screen. They're at 86 subscribers. So you want coverage on your favorite team? You go to this link, chatsports.com/teamTV, or just enter your team name TV, and you can subscribe to the channel. You get to 100 subs, we'll do a mailbag video for you guys. And maybe, just maybe, that's the next channel we commit to here at Chat Sports. But like I mentioned, Cardinals fans, congratulations on crossing 100 subs on the Cardinals channel. Use hashtag Cardinals for a future mailbag video. We'll pump that out over the next few days. Congrats again, and use hashtag Cardinals. We got some more NFL news here, an offseason update, if you will. They have extended the virtual offseason program to June 26th. There's not going to be in-person mini camps, at least in the month of June. Maybe they do something early in July before training camps. And speaking of training camps, still no official word on start dates there. Typically third or fourth week in July. NFL would like to start on time. Maybe that happens. Maybe it doesn't. I think it depends, you know, kind of state to state. Like here in the state of Texas, they could pretty much start right now with how we've been progressing with the pandemic. But other states, not so much. So keep that in mind. And then also some more notes as well is that the NFL is considering trimming down the preseason. More on that in a second. But here's Brian McCarthy, NFL league spokesman, saying we will continue working with the NFLPA to conclude the remaining protocols and finalize arrangements for the safe opening of training camps next month. So not a major update for as far as training camps are concerned, but again, they have extended the virtual offseason program. Here's Tom Pelissero on the potential of trimming the preseason, saying the NFL and NFLPA are discussing the possibility of shortening the 2020 preseason per sources. Nothing finalized or imminent, but multiple team executives have formed of talks currently believe they could end up playing two preseason games rather than four. How about this? Don't just make that 2020. Can that just be the way moving forward? Two games? We don't need four preseason games. Some teams play five if they're in the Hall of Fame game. I'm voting two on this question. How many preseason games do you guys think there should be? Two, three, or four? I do think you need at least two. You don't need four, though. I think it's two or three, but I'm typing two. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section. We got an update on Henry Ruggs. Of course, that bizarre story where he got, like, pinned in between a trailer and a truck. while helping a buddy move, a couple of weeks ago. Luckily, nothing major here. Adam Schefter reporting that, yeah, he got some stitches in his thigh, but no muscular damage from that moving incident. So he's healthy. He's good to go. He's going to be ready once training camp arrives, whenever that is. So that is a good sign for the Las Vegas Raiders, considering they drafted him number 12 overall, the number one receiver in this year's NFL draft. And he's expected to have an instant impact. You know, big play receiver, almost 19 yards a catch last year at Alabama and 7 touchdowns, should give them some special teams value as well. So positive signs for the Raiders, positive signs for Henry Ruggs. That potentially could have been a scary, scary story, but just a couple of stitches. He's good to go. He'll be ready to go once training camp gets here, hopefully in late July.